Hello everyone, it's that time again. Prayer for South Africa. Amen. We have the privilege of lifting our nation up before our God for peace and prosperity over our nation. We want to give thanks for what God has done this week in terms of those who stood in the dock for the Babita Deokoran assassination, for those that are still standing in the dock for the Shaul Kinnear assassination. And we want justice to roll down like a river. Amen. And that God would completely turn this situation around and make this a case for all to see, a prize, a position in a sense for the justice and the law enforcement system of our nation. Amen. That this would be a case for all to see that God is moving in this area in our nation. Amen. That he would move swiftly and bring justice so swiftly that it would roll down like a river. Amen. The first thing we want to pray for is the process of choosing the Chief Justice. A new Chief Justice is about to be chosen. And so we're praying and we decree impartiality in the decision making. This would be a man that would honor and he would serve South Africa well. Proverbs 8, 15 and 16 says, "By me kings reign and rulers issue decrees that are just." They issue decrees that are just. Why? Because justice and righteousness is the foundation of God's throne. And that's what we envisage. A just and a righteous chief justice for our nation, a just and a righteous judicial system, one that serves the poor, one that serves this nation. And just as Mordecai was one who stood beside the king, and the Bible says that he served his people well, we decree and we declare today, Almighty God, for your hand to move in this area, Lord, for your hand for the one that you have chosen. We pray for our president, Lord, that he would make a wise choice, that you would speak to him in dreams and visions in the night season, that he would have an encounter with you, Lord, in terms of the one that you have chosen and set aside for this office, for the future of our nation, in Jesus' name. And we thank you, Lord. We thank you for the testimony that will arise from this, in Jesus' name. That you will silence the voices, that you will silence the enemy, that, Lord, those that would try and whisper in our president's ears, that you would silence those voices. And I thank you that he will hear you concerning this one that is to be chosen, in Jesus' name. Point two. We're praying for our local government elections, for new governors, those that are called to serve the city, those that are called to rule, those that are called to stand in the gap. And it says in 1 Peter 2:14, governors who are sent by him, amen, to punish those who do wrong and to commend those who do right. God has prepared these men and women ahead of time. Those that have a moral and a civil conscience. Those that are servants to the people. We call them forth in Jesus' mighty name. And we decree their protection. We decree that the schemes of the wicked are cut off. We decree today that the schemes of the wicked are confused. And even those that would rise up even in this day and this hour, and that would prevent the outcome of this election and try and manipulate and try and scheme and try and decree their will and their own purposes for selfish and wicked gain. We decree that those plans are being brought to naught. And we petition your mighty God today that you would favor, that you would rule in favor. We pray, Almighty God, for our Concord judges as they set this time aside and they decide. We thank you for the mind of Christ, that their hearts, Lord, are turned towards the people, and that, Lord, that we decree today by your almighty authority that is within us, that the Constitution will not be changed. But Lord, we thank you that the schemes of the enemy are brought to naught, and that our governors for a new season of government in this nation are arising, Lord. We decree it and we thank you for it in Jesus' mighty name. And then lastly, we want to pray and bless the nation of Israel. From the 6th to the 8th of September is their new year season, which is Rosh, Hashanah, and we want to just wish our brothers and our sisters Shana Tova, which is Happy New Year in Hebrew. And we want to pray blessing over them. We want to thank God for their sacrifice. We want to thank God for the way they laid themselves down, the sacrifice that they made in Egypt, going through the Red Sea. And we just want to say thank you to our Jewish brothers and our Jewish sisters today, to the nation of Israel. And we decree in Jesus' name that there will come a new season of alignment over South Africa, of alignment towards Israel, in our relationship with Israel. We decree that in the spirit realm today, and we, as we set ourselves aside for this time, and we prepare our own hearts, that we would be in a place that we would be sensitive, that we would be in a place that we would be able to serve Israel in prayer, especially during this time, that Israel would be kept safe, that every plan of the enemy would be reverted, amen, and distorted. We decree it that it will not prosper. And so we thank you today for our Jewish brothers. We thank you for the alignment of Israel and South Africa. And we thank you, Lord, for this Shemitah year, that as we move into it, that the blessings of God would come upon our nations, Lord. And as we commit South Africa to you, Lord, we petition you and we ask you, God, that you would move in terms of the Israeli and the South African relationships for the blessing of God on this nation, in Jesus' mighty name. Well, South Africa, continue to pray for our police stations. Remember, Wednesday is the day that we set aside to fast for our nations. We go and we pray at our police stations and our local government offices on a Wednesday, and we decree that Wednesdays are set aside, amen, that God would move and that God would continue to bring forth righteousness and justice in our nation. And so as we prepare for a new season of governance, let's keep petitioning the heavens. Let's keep petitioning Almighty God for His will, for His hand to move, for strength for our governance, for strength and protection for our nation. Amen. That the plans of the enemy would be brought to naught. Amen. And that they would be destroyed in Jesus' mighty name. God bless you. Amen.